Various issues have surfaced regarding overseas voting these past few weeks. Social media users have reported allegations of pre-shaded ballots. There's also a post claiming the voter received two ballots, and there were also some concerns over shortage of postage stamps. The concerned Philippine embassies and consulates general have issued statements on these matters. To discuss these issues further, we are joined this morning by COMELEC Commissioner Marlon Casquejo. Commissioner, good morning. Welcome back to the program.
Good morning, Mike, and good morning to everyone.
First, Commissioner, let me just get some update on the overseas voting. How is the turnout so far? Do we have figures? And how do these compare to previous elections?
Our overseas voting right now is very much interesting because, you know, in the first day, there are so many voters, overseas voters who want to vote. So we are expecting a much higher voting turnout as compared in 2016 and 2019 elections.
Mm-hmm. Do we have figures at the moment, Commissioner? How many percent are voted, have already voted?
Well, in some countries, like for example in Hong Kong, about 30% already voted. Mm-hmm. And in some other countries, they reported about 20%. So ngayon, for this early early time of period of voting, we have already reached our target, which is more than 30%. So we're expecting a higher voting turnout for our overseas voting. You know, in the last, in the previous elections, you only have about 20% or even mm-hmm. less than 20% voting turnout.
Okay. So this is a marked improvement compared to the previous polls, Commissioner.
Yes, that is correct. Because we introduced some scheme like the Vote Anywhere concept and also the field registration, field voting.
How does that work, the Vote Anywhere concept and the field voting or field registration?
Well, field voting, when we say field voting, our consul, our embassy will go to the area where our overseas voters are residing. So there are issues kasi that the distance between the embassy and where our kababayan resides is too far. So they have to travel 2 to 3 hours. So what we did is the consul and the embassy together with the SBEI will go to that area and then conduct the voting. And all right. For the Vote Anywhere concept also is that even if you are registered in another country and so happened during the voting period, you are in another country, you are allowed to vote.
All right. Now, Commissioner, let's discuss some of the allegations that were posted online. First, the issue of pre-shaded ballots. There's a photo circulating online, supposedly of a ballot that pre-shaded with the presidential and vice presidential candidate. Have you checked if this particular photo is authentic? And have you looked into if there are other cases, similar other complaints about pre-shaded ballots?
Well, the only issue that came about is about regarding the Singapore PE. Which it's not a pre-shaded ballot, but it is a spoiled ballot. It was explained by our Consul General of Singapore that it was not really a pre-shaded ballot. With regards to the photo, we verified the said photo. Number one, you cannot take picture of your ballot. That is a clear violation of the election laws, the sanctity of our ballot. So you cannot do that. So if you took a picture and then post it in the Facebook, we can file an election offense against you. So we tried to verify the said ballot and it was not authentic. So it's a fake news that it's a pre-shaded ballot.
When you say, sir, it was not authenticated, what do you mean? You're saying there's no such ballot, or are you saying that you cannot trace the source of that supposedly particular ballot?
Well,
Can you repeat that, Commissioner?
It's not a ballot that being distributed by our post. Maybe it was edited ballot or whatsoever. Because number two, we cannot trace it also which precinct or post it is located.
So, but have you been able to talk to the person who supposedly posted this particular photo?
Not at this moment. We're trying to contact the person through the consul wherever it was posted.
All right. Now, Commissioner, you did mention that there was this issue about in Singapore, precisely, exactly in Singapore, where there was a spoiled ballot that was given to a voter, and that now has been considered as supposedly the appreciated ballot. You're saying it's not appreciated ballot. What measures are we taking to ensure that that similar scenario will not happen again?
Well, we give an advisory to our SBDI, to our consuls, that before giving it to the voters, they must check. They must check first the ballot, that the ballot is clean, the ballot has no shade, the ballot is not spoiled. So it's an isolated incident. It happened only once in Singapore PE, but in other polls, never happened.
Mm-hmm. And aren't spoiled ballots supposed to be torn in the presence of the voter himself?
It has to be marked as spoiled and separated in an envelope for a spoiled ballot.
So there's no need to tear it apart, Commissioner?
No, it will be separated in an envelope, separate envelope for a spoiled ballot.
All right. Now, there's also this post from a Filipino voter receiving two ballots. The Philippine Embassy in Sweden said there were only three incidents. It said they based it on the list of the COMELEC certified list of overseas absentee voters, or CLOAV. Now, assuming both ballots are sent to the Philippine Embassy, what assurance do we have that only one of those two ballots will be counted?
Well, once the embassy receives the ballot coming from the overseas voter, they will check in the election day computerized voters list. In our EDCVL, the list of the names of the ballot. If that ballot already registered, then we will not count the other ballots if the voters receive two ballots.
But Commissioner, if the embassy was not able to check upon sending these ballots that there were in fact two ballots sent, what's the assurance that they could also check that these two ballots are not counted for one person?
Well, in our general instructions, we have to count the number of mail packets being sent and received. So the actual number of voters must also reflect as to the number of voters overseas ballot already sent and received back. So we make sure that every time it is found in the general instructions, once received the ballot coming from the overseas voters, they have to check individually.
So there's another layer of checking. So kahit nagkamali, Commissioner, so kahit nagkamali sa pagpapadala, for example, dalawa yung padala, pagbalik niyan, there's another layer of checking to ensure that two ballots are not counted for one. Okay.
Yes.
All right. Now, one other issue is the shortage of postage stamps, particularly in the United States. The Philippine Consulate General in San Francisco has advised voters to either add one USPS Forever stamp or to send the ballot envelope as is, and the deficiency will be paid by the consulate. But what would explain, Commissioner, the shortage of these postage stamps?
It's the budget. We have already sent the budget to the post regarding the postage, because the postage must be from sending to the voters and sending it back. So it's a matter of the budget that is given. But we have already sent additional budget to the post regarding the postage.
You did mention the budget. There was a drastic reduction in terms of the budget. So you were proposing more than 510 million, or about 510 million pesos, but only 111 million pesos was given to the COMELEC. How did you try to remedy this?
Well, we asked in the NBank, during NBank meeting, we asked for additional budget. Since we have some savings from other budget, so we were given additional budget of 345 million. That is why we were able to conduct field voting, and also the postage. We were able to give additional budget for the postage of the mailing packet.
Mm-hmm. But were there prior notices sent, Commissioner, to the voters telling them or advising them that the postage stamp may be short, that you need to add an additional stamp? Because the statement from the Philippine Consulate General in San Francisco came after the issues already surfaced. But before that, were there in any notices sent to the voters, at least?
Well, what we said to our post and consuls, that the postage back will be paid by the COMELEC. So there were no such advice at the time. So as now, we already sent additional budget for the said postage. So there will be no problem for the voters to advance the payment of the postage.
Mm-hmm. So what would happen, Commissioner, in case the postage is short of the required postage stamp? There were concerns that this will not go to the embassy or the consulate general?
Well, for now, we gave an advisory to our consuls that we are sending additional budget for that. So to make sure there's that no the ballots will go back, will be received by the embassy.
So, Commissioner, there's no danger that the ballot will not be received by the embassy or the consulate general?
There's no such danger on such issue.
All right.
We already received that.
All right, great. Now, one more issue, Commissioner, the wrong spelling of the word Philippine on a ballot in Vietnam. So Philippine with double L instead of two P's. Now, this may seem trivial, but the question posted by the poster online, if you can get away with the wrong spelling, how certain are they that the COMELEC or the Philippine Embassy can safeguard their votes?
Well, I have to check where is that wrong spelling. Is it in a official ballot? Because I don't think the official ballot will get the wrong spelling. Maybe
we're showing it now. All right, Commissioner, yes. We're showing it now on screen. I don't know if you can see it from where you're sitting. The wrong spelling is actually in the Philippine Embassy in Hanoi. So the word Philippine was misspelled, double L. I don't know if, have you come across this, Commissioner? Are you investigating this as well?
Not yet, as of this moment, not yet. But I think it has nothing to do with the elections because it's more on the mail packet in the envelope, but not in the ballot itself.
It was on the ballot itself, Commissioner. There's a list of whom you're voting for. I don't know if that's the standard ballot, though. Can you tell us what a ballot, overseas ballot, looks like? Is it similar in all places, or are there differences in terms of the physical makeup of a ballot?
Well, we only have one ballot phase for the entire overseas. So if it happens in Vietnam, it should happen also in other countries. So I think it's not the ballot that has the wrong spelling.
All right. We will check on that, Commissioner. What about delays in overseas voting in some countries? Will there be a reason to extend the voting period for these countries?
Well, we have a 30-day period for the voting. That's the good thing about overseas voting. Even if we have some delays, we can still conduct the elections. So there's no problem with such 1 or 2 days delay, even 1 week delay, because our consul can still conduct elections. In some areas, there are only 670 plus voters because of the delay. Like, for example, in Dili, in Timor-Leste, we only have 679 voters, and it's in-person voting. Even if there's such a delay of, let us say, 2 days, 3 days, or even 1 week, the consul can still conduct the elections because the number of voters is less.
So no need for extension, Commissioner?
Yes, no need for extension. We have to close the polls at May 9, 7 p.m. Philippine time.
What about the voters in Ukraine, Commissioner? What happens to them? Because most of them probably have already evacuated by now. So in terms of how can they vote?
Well, in Ukraine, in some other areas like Afghanistan, in areas where security risks, where our consul cannot conduct elections, the election is suspended. But as we count all the registered voters in that area, only 127. So it's easier for them to conduct special elections once the security is already okay in that area in Ukraine. But for now, we only have 15 voters in Ukraine, and we need to suspend the election in Ukraine because of that war.
So only in Ukraine, Commissioner? How many other areas?
We have one in Syria. Not in Syria, in Afghanistan. And I think it's Iraq. But we have less voters in that area.
All right. Now, Commissioner, what other challenges are you facing with respect to overseas voting?
Well, for now, we have less challenges except only for the issues. I'd like to raise this issue because you failed to question me or ask me about this with regards to the issue on the Facebook regarding similar ballot serial ID number. So there's an issue in Milan where a voter posted or even in the Facebook that they have similar ballot ID number. So I just want to clarify what is ballot ID number. Ballot ID number is an identifier of the vote counting machines. each voting counting machines can accept 1,000 ballots. So what he is saying is they have similar ballot ID number. We are expecting 1,000 similar ballot ID number, but with different ballot serial number. So that is we want to clarify.
So in this particular issue, Commissioner, you have checked the photos posted online, and you're sure that the numbers there refer not to the serial number of the ballots, but to the vote counting machine, supposedly, which could accommodate 1,000 ballots. So same 1,000 ballots with the same vote counting machine number. Is that right, Commissioner?
1,000 ballots with the same ballot ID number. Ballot ID number refers to the country code, the postcode, and the machine number. So we are expecting 1,000 similar ballot ID number, but with different ballot serial number.
Now, Commissioner, I don't know if you can comment on this, but the Comelec First Division yesterday junked the remaining Marcos disqualification case at the division level. But at the unbanked level, when are we expecting a decision? Because previously there was a statement that it should be done by the end of April or by third week of April. Will the Comelec be able to meet that deadline?
Well, I cannot give an exact date regarding of that unbanked decision coming from the First Division first, because we have to check whether if there will be a motion for reconsideration that will be raised to the NBank. So maybe, I don't know, with this timeline we have right now, near election, I don't know what timeline can I give you right now. So I have no definite answer.
What about the other cases, Commissioner, which were earlier brought to the NBank level?
Well, already in the NBank, our chairperson, Chairman Saidamin Pangarungan, already informed us that we have to release this before the election.
All right. Now, lastly, Commissioner, if you can comment on what's the status of your investigation on the shooting incident involving presidential candidate Calio Didi Guzman. Were there initial findings already? Because the PNP said it's not election-related. But on the part of the Comelec, what are you finding out? And in relation also to the gun ban, the Guzman is asking, what happened to the enforcement of the gun ban? How come there are security personnel, or goons as they call them, having guns during an election period?
She's a commissioner of this moment, Commissioner Ferolino, and it is under their jurisdiction, and now they are conducting investigation on that matter.
All right. Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us this morning, Comelec Commissioner Marlon Casqueo.
Thank you. Thank you very much.